progressives are on the hunt for new candidates to replace the very few but very old real progressive leaders in Washington. You know, before we came on the set, I said, I can't think of anybody that I want to that I would want to put in that slot. Give me some names. I mean, we're talking about Bernie quality.
Yeah.
We're talking about Elizabeth Warren kind of quality candidate. What do you think?
Well, you know, we've talked a lot about just the aging problem with the Democratic Party, but on the actual progressive side, yeah, we've got two people. Bernie's 81, she's in her early 70s. They're kind of aged out, and people understand that. They're not going to run again in 2024, and honestly, they shouldn't.
No,
Bernie Sanders at 83 should not run. Love the guy, but it's not happening. So the question is, who carries the torch? Who is out there actually fighting against corporations, fighting for workers? A couple names to me come to mind. Katie Porter out in California. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you really like her.
I really like Katie Porter.
Every time you talk about Katie Porter, you light up.
I am just absolutely loving Katie Porter because you watch her on the House floor during these hearings, taking on these CEOs better than anybody I've seen.
She's smart, isn't
she?
I mean, and she's not afraid. She's you know, obviously when she takes on these big corporations, they dry up money to her, but she doesn't seem to be afraid of that. Anybody else you can think of?
Possibly Ro Khanna. He's actually also from California. Mm-hmm. He actually served as kind of Bernie's right-hand man during his 2020 presidential campaign. Mm-hmm. So he's very much like Bernie. He's got baggage. You know, we actually brought him up recently talking about the insider trading stuff.
His wife,
his family. So
it's pretty ugly story.
That's what turns me off about him now. But Katie Porter, I've dug. I don't see the baggage. She's not somebody that the conservative media has been out there trashing for years, which is a problem that the squad has.
Yeah.
They've been so tarnished by right-wing media, I don't think they could have broad appeal.
As I watched the squad.
And I like them.
They do some good things.
Yeah.
I don't know whether they just don't do it right or whether the media is just so set in, and they don't, you know, corporate media does not like progressives. I mean, they may act like they do. You may watch MSNBC and you may say, they really have kinship with progressives. They don't.
We know firsthand behind the scenes stuff. They hate progressives at MSNBC.
I did MSNBC, as you know, for a long time. You were one of the producers that worked with me when I'd be on a couple times a week. And they rarely let you tell the story. So for us to believe that progressives have an easy run with media and that they're going to support, that'll be the problem with Katie Porter, won't it?
Yeah.
The problem will be they will do everything they can to discredit her.
Right. But actually, too, if you look at Katie Porter's voting record, she does have a very moderate coming across voting record.
Okay.
So she's not super extreme. But the fact that she takes on corporate power and does advocate for workers, the working class, consumers, that's the kind of thing we need. And in her mold, we could bring more people in that way.
Yeah, maybe we can ask as people watch this, you send in your comments, give us some ideas.
We need more names.
Farron, thank you for joining me, okay?
Thank you.
That's all for this week, but all these segments are going to be available this coming week right here on this channel, and you can follow us on Twitter at America's Lawyer. I'm Mike Papantonio, and this has been America's Lawyer, where every week we tell you the stories that corporate media won't tell you because their advertisers won't let them and their political connections don't allow for it. We'll see you next time.